Well, I'm glad we,
had sex.
Bingo! That's it. Plainly put. Can I get you a beer?
Oh, well, it's kind of late. Well, all right, but what about your wife?
Let me ask her. Honey, would you like a beer?
Oh, I don't know. A beer, I think I'm about ready to call it a night. I had no idea a three-way was going to be quite so demanding.
Are you okay, Fran?
Oh, yeah, no, fine, yeah, don't get me wrong, it was fun, yeah. Couple awkward moments, but,
Certainly wasn't anything like my fantasy.
Yeah.
a little trickier. I was pretty nervous. But then I sure kicked it into gear, though, didn't I? All aboard!
it was an eye-opener, that's for sure. I saw a blissful expression on my husband's face, which I enjoyed watching from the on-deck circle. So there's a gift. You know, I'm gonna get the recycling together for tomorrow morning.
You know what, Fran? Why don't we just all sit down here for a minute?
All right.
Yeah. Well, you know, I had a good time, but maybe if everybody, you know, had been a little more loving and hadn't just cussed each other so much, I don't know. Well, maybe I should just go.
Oh, no, Gabby. I don't want anyone to leave here upset, because that is not what this was supposed to be about.
No. And Gabby, we don't want to lose you as our babysitter. You know, we've spent a lot of time together, and you have really helped us with Caleb. So let's just talk this out, all right? Fran, you seem to want to say something?
Well, you know, I just thought that everyone would maybe get their needs met a little better, okay? I'm sorry.
All right. Gabby, did you experience that?
Well, the opposite. I felt like I wasn't giving back enough, but you guys seem really into me.
But were you satisfied?
Of course she was. She served up a delicious entree, which you enjoyed for the better part of an hour. A meal, I might add, that I have offered up on multiple occasions, only to be left cold and uneaten.
I only did that for a couple of minutes, Fran. I did it for her.
You know, it felt like an eternity. I mean, I was parked up there on the bureau in my bra, and I sat there like a bump on a log for a very long time.
Come on, Fran.
Oh, come on yourself. Oh, and thank you for waiting until I was pulling on my slacks to point out that I had a secrets and a nickel stuck to my ass.
I would have told you, Mrs. Kearney, but I thought it had something to do with you having Caleb.
Fran, do you think maybe this all goes back to your poor body image?
I had a baby 11 months ago, Warren, all right? So I'm sorry if I'm a little insecure about the huge ass and stomach I acquired giving birth to our son. I'm not Michelle Pfeiffer, Warren. I'm Fran Kearney.
You know, Mrs. Kearney, the average American woman is a size 14. I'm a size 2, you know, and I feel freakish, just on the other side of the scale.
God, I am so tired of hearing about women's bodies. Now look at me. I'm a good-looking man, but not great-looking. I've got a gut that I can't get rid of, no matter how much time I spend on the stationary bike. I'm not that tall.
Napoleon comes to mind.
Okay. Let me finish, Fran, then I'll get up on the coffee table and you can hurl insults at me, all right? All I'm saying is that I'm comfortable with my body.
This coming from the man who kept his T-shirt on the entire time during our little escapade up there.
You did fight me pretty hard when I tried to take it off.
Well, I can see I'm being tag-teamed by the lesbians.
I was just experimenting.
Warren, the only reason that Gabby and I got together was to kill time while you got your little boat back in the water.
We would have been down here a lot earlier if you would have copped to the fact that you were spent.
Well, I can see nobody's gonna get out of this thing alive.
Well, look, maybe it's time for me to go.
No, let me drive you back to the dorm.
Uh-uh, you are not driving her anywhere.
I'm fine, well, don't worry about it.
Well, how much do we owe you?
God, Mr. Kearney, I'm not a whore.
I meant for the babysitting.
Warren, this is Gabby you're talking to. She takes care of Caleb. She went to your brother's wedding. This is practically family.
Okay, well, this is starting to get a little weird, so I'm just going to go to my boyfriend's house. I'll crash there tonight.
Okay, well, be careful, Gabby.
All right, Gabby, take care. Don't forget about Caleb's christening on Sunday.
Yeah, we'd love to have you there.
Well, that is not something we will do again.
You want to watch the tape?
Yeah, just fast forward when I tell you to.
Okay.
All right.